You want to use a pressure washer but you can't get one, simply because you don't have a water tap and plug around your car? Well, while your current situation might be annoying, in this video I'm going to give you an in-depth review about the new Fixno 500e portable pressure washer by answering the 5 most important questions you have, starting with number 1, what do you get for your money? So once you open the very well presented package, you get the user manual and find the main components right in front of you. First, the main power washer unit, with specifications I will talk about more detailed throughout the whole video. Then, a 24V 2.6 amp hour battery pack in the current state of charge plus its charger. Mine came with the standard EU type plug, but obviously it depends on the country you live. A filter to prevent junk from going to the inside of the machine, a spray lens with the instructions and adjustable nozzle head, but that's not all. When you dig deeper, you find a navy colored carrying case that I think is brilliant. Makes the whole portable idea even better, as you won't need to carry the box with you and seems to be very practical, I like it. A small plastic foam or soap cannon with adjustable head and top that looks very impressive in this category, and you will see how it performs a bit later. A blue soft plush towel and a short pile microfiber wash mitt that feels soft too. A 6 meters long suction hose with a quick release type of fitting. A clip which helps to hold the hose on the mouth of the bucket, and the last thing is a foldable own-branded bucket. The stuff you have for the money is a good value, and I can see that the company did their market research fairly well. For full disclosure, the company did send me this package for the purpose of this review, free of charge with the freedom of my words, and with that being said, let's continue with question number 2, how easy is to use? The user manual is very detailed, you really find every information you will need from the assembly to troubleshooting. So let's put everything together, and first, fill up the bucket with water, where I use a 1.5 liter bottle to calculate an approximately capacity of the bucket. But I don't fill that all the way up, because I will need to carry that elsewhere, and spilling the water out is the last thing I want. All in all, my measurement gives an at least 12 liter capacity with a bit of an empty room on top, but you will see that later how far we can go with that towards the end of the video. Also, because the water source I have is far from me, I prepared 2 extra buckets to make the refill more convenient for the test. The 6 meters long suction hose is fairly kinky out of the box, so straightening that by your hand is ideal before you attach the filter to the end. Once it has been done, pair up the pressure washer unit with its battery pack, which clicks into its place very easily. Push in and twist the spray lens, then connect the suction hose with the quick release fitting. Also, make sure you have done it right, just in case. Now, you are ready to unlock the two-way security button by pushing that out to either side, then pull the trigger and fire up the system. While the washer gets the water in, let me show you my favorite feature, the digital display, and I like this the most, because you have continuous visible feedback about the pressure settings and the remaining battery life. So once we have the water in, which by the way takes around 10 to 15 seconds, it's finally time to see that in action, as well as move on to question number 3, what performance and results you can expect. Usually the wheels are the dirtiest part from all, so that's the best place to start from. The T1 setting has the lowest water flow out of the 3, so I don't think it will be enough for this job, regardless adjusting the nozzle, so I step up to T2, which seems to have a much stronger water flow already, but this wheel might need some extra punch, and the strongest setting seems to provide a decent enough power and water flow. As I wanted to keep the use of other products and equipments as minimal as possible, I start with Built Humber Surfax HD diluted 10% in the foam cannon, and the top has been adjusted for maximum detergent flow as well. I know the camera lost focus, but I can tell you that the foam has more likely a wet consistency, and that is what to be expected in my opinion, although the amount of solution on the surface is more than decent. I also topped up the brushes with more APC for the best results, because the tire especially was in a desperate need of some TLC. After scrubbing enough, I use the strongest setting again to rinse everything off, then I give the tire a second chemical hit, then a third, because the tires in general were very filthy and I think they haven't been cleaned properly since a good while. the bodywork is in a much cleaner condition, only the plastic and rubber parts will need some extra care. I usually start with a rinse off on the bodywork as well, but if I use a portable pressure washer, I skip that step because I want to use less water. Also, the foam what I'm going to use in the Canon will help to soften up the dirt on the paintwork, but before I get there, I share a few things about the Soap Canon itself. My previous measurements show that the capacity of the bottle is approximately 400 milliliters, the cap goes on very easily, and we have two features which I haven't seen yet from any other brand in this category. One of them is being the changeable direction on the nozzle, and the other one is the ability of changing the volume of mixture on the top. No, it's not leak-proof, and this fact doesn't make me happy. By the way, a 50 euro Verse foam cannon can't offer this feature either, so it's probably not a big deal, and this foam cannon still has the best available feature on the portable market in my opinion. And the fact that you actually connect this with the main unit directly makes the Fixno 500E even more portable, and that's a big step to take because the spray lens creates extra pressure by being long. No wonders why other brands on the market use that kind of solution. But that's not the case here, and I really like that. However, I wish it could have a bigger capacity because I like to put at least two layers of foam on the car, but I needed to refill the foam bottle two times to achieve that. The foam you can get is sort of the same wet consistency as before, although I used Bild Humber Auto Wash in the foam cannon. That's a highly concentrated, typical low foaming shampoo and hasn't been made for use as a pre-wash or in a foam cannon. But I thought it's going to be a good experiment. In fact, I had put only 5 ml auto wash in the foam bottle, and other than running down far too quick, I'm happy with it. Yes, I love to see nice thick foam on the car as well, but you need an electric power washer to achieve that, and now we are not in that league. So you need to accept a few limitations when we are talking about cordless pressure washers in general, and what you can get here with the Fixno 500E is decent enough in my opinion. If you want that thick snow foam heaven, portable pressure washers aren't for you, unfortunately. Although thick foam doesn't necessarily cleans better than a thin, wet kind of foam, but this is another topic to cover. So once the plastic and rubber parts has been agitated and the soap was dwelling around 8 to 10 minutes, it's time to rinse that off before it dries. I made a huge mistake at the beginning of filming this video because I was too excited and went straight into the middle, but I forget to fully charge the battery before use, and I realized that mistake only when the indicator showed an empty battery. It was too late to turn back then, but the good thing about this that I can show you what happens in the situation if this would happen with you in the middle of a car wash. First, obviously I was panicked, but I couldn't stop because the soap has been on the car over 10 minutes, so I kept going, but the power washer took over the lead and lowered the strength of the water flow to save energy. And all I can say is that, even with lowered water flow, the performance is still good enough for this job. Then moved on with a 1 bucket mat hood for the contact wash. Why 1 bucket? Because with the portable pressure washer you need to manage every drop of water what you will use. And while the best solution for water saving would be a foam on and agitate type of wash, using 1 bucket of water with shampoo for the contact wash gives me the best peace of mind. Also, I can rinse off the wash mitt with the pressure washer before further dumping the soapy water, so it seems to be a good way in the middle for me. With that being said, let's see the answer of question number 4, how much water you will need. The best way to answer this question is to show you the exact water flow for 1 minute at each settings. With the lowest T1 setting, the water flow was approximately 2 liters or 0.53 gallon water per minute. With T2 setting, a bit over on 3 liters or 0.8 gallon water per minute. And with the strongest setting, 3.4 liters or 0.9 gallon water per minute. That exactly matches with the official claims by the manufacturer, what you can see right now alongside with the information of the pressure rates. All in all, this data gives you a rough idea about water usage, also means you are going to empty the 12 liter buckets within 3 minutes on the strongest setting, 4 minutes on T2 and 6 minutes on T1. I think at least the strength of the T2 setting is needed for optimal result, and if the condition of the car requires, there is one step above that with the strongest setting. I like the strongest setting the most, and I used 5 liters of water for each wheel, 10 liters for foam and rinse, and I probably would have used another 10 liters for the final rinse. But hence the battery went flat, I needed to put that on a charger on the night before the water flow tests, and it means we arrive to question number 5, how long the battery lasts and takes to recharge. The battery capacity is fairly big with 15,600 mAh, but the package includes only a normal charger, so it does take a little while, 3 hours and 43 minutes, until it will be fully charged. So, let the numbers speak for themselves and see the results of the next day. I used 3 minutes in mixed settings at the beginning, then continued with the strongest setting for a further 10 minutes until the indicator showed an empty battery, but I could kept going for a further 5 minutes, which makes a total of 18 minutes running time before the battery went fully flat. So, overall, I really like the FixNow 500E pressure washer. I found it more powerful than a Works HydroShot, which you can see here, although I would prefer a quick charger as an option. Other than that, the range of accessories included is above the market average, so if you need more info, make sure to check the link in description below. If you have a question, don't hesitate to comment, feel free to subscribe, like, turn on notification bell, and be the first who knows when a new video drops. Until then, click here, take care, see you soon.